Good morning and welcome, class 10 students. In today's class, we are going to learn about male reproductive system in human. Here in this picture you can see, it is showing the side view of male reproductive system in human body. The male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes on both sides of the body. The testes remain inside the membranous sac-like structure called scrotum. So this scrotum remains in the outside of the body cavity basically. So in a hanging condition, so testes is hanging in the abdominal portion outside the abdominal cavity. Now the next parts are coiled epididymis, which is followed by vas deferens or sperm duct. Sperm duct is a very important part, tube-like structure, which carries the sperm produced in testes. Sperm duct passes through the abdominal cavity and on the way, there are certain other glands like seminal vesicle, prostate gland, which add their secretion to the sperm duct. The interesting feature is that urinary bladder, that is the exit of urinary bladder and the sperm duct, both follow a common exit, that is urethra. So the sperm duct finally meets with the urethra, and so penis is the, in human male body, penis is the common passage for urine and sperm. Therefore, penis is the copulatory organ which help in the process of sexual copulation during intercourse. So testes are the primary reproductive organ in human male body. Its major function is, its main functions are, first of all, production of sperms. Next, production of the male reproductive hormone, that is testosterone. Testosterone is produced from testes, and it has a major part in controlling the primary sexual characteristics as well as the secondary sexual characteristics in human male. Secondary sexual characteristics involve the changes during puberty. So during puberty, sharp changes appear from small boys to the grown-up boys. Therefore, testosterone play a very important role in the expressions of secondary sexual characteristics in human male body. The main role of testes is to produce the sperm, human sperm, which is the human male gamete, and growth and expression of the features of sperm. Sperm is the male gamete, which finally fuses with the female gamete, that is ovum or egg, during the process of fertilization. So sperms are produced numerous in number in a human male body. So sperms produced from testes passes through this coiled structure epididymis and then enters into the sperm duct or vas deferens, passes through this. Seminal vesicle is the gland which added the liquid called semen into the sperm duct. Semen provides nourishment to the sperms and help in the movement. Prostate gland also secrete its secretions which help in nourishment of the sperm. And finally the sperm passes through the penis. Now we'll see the different parts of the female reproductive system in human. Human female reproductive system involve a pair of ovaries hanging from the body cavity, that is the back wall of the body cavity. The central part is the uterus or womb, mother's womb. Uterus has two horn-shaped structure both sides, which are the oviduct or fallopian tube. Fallopian tube has funnel-shaped structures, which are the receiving parts of ovum or egg from the ovary. Fallopian tube has the receiving ends funnel-shaped structure called funnel of oviduct. So the ovaries, fallopian tube, funnel, uterus, cervix and vagina, these are the different parts in the female reproductive system in human body. During copulation, penis is the part through which sperms are transferred into the female body. Sperms are transferred into the female body through this vaginal end of the reproductive system. Through vagina, cervix, uterus, finally sperms reach to the fallopian tube. So the functions of ovary, the primary function of ovary is to produce the egg or ovum, and also it produces the female reproductive hormones like estrogen, progesterone, which control the expression of the secondary sexual characters in female body. Here in this picture we can see the original figures of sperms, highly magnified and highly magnified egg or ovum. So during the process of fertilization, sperms enter through vagina, finally through the uterus and in the fallopian tube. Egg, so a single egg is produced every month from any of the ovaries. Due to the concept of puberty and menstruation, single egg is produced from any of the ovary in the female system. This egg is fertilized by the sperm. So fertilization takes place to form a fertilized egg or zygote. Fertilization takes place to form the fertilized egg or zygote inside the fallopian tube. By the time soft and thick lining of uterus is formed, here you can see, sperms swim through the uterus, go to the oviduct, and soft and thick lining of uterus is formed here. Fertilization is followed by implantation of embryo in the uterus. After the zygote is formed due to fertilization, it divides into two cells to four cells, 4 to 8, 8 to 16, 16 to 32, likewise, and finally it forms into a ball of cell. This ball of cell is known as embryo. This embryo is then implanted or embedded on the uterine wall. So this is the ball of hundreds of cells, now called an embryo. This embryo is then placed over the uterine wall and embedded in the uterine wall. This is known as, this process is called implantation of embryo in the uterus. So once the embryo is embedded, then it grows into a new baby within 8th to 9th month. Here you can see the baby is attached to the special tissue called placenta with the help of this tissue called umbilical cord. So the embryo remains attached to the placental tissue with the umbilical cord. So here this is the source of nutrition exchange of nutrients, oxygen, waste products between the embryo and the mother's body, that is placenta, is done through the umbilical cord. Here in this picture you can see embryo grows and develops inside the uterus or womb and becomes a fetus. Here we can see the different parts of the growing baby. So now it is called the, now this is known as a fetus. Finally, this figure shows a just born baby. So the fetus finally transform into the whole structure of the human being. So that is how fertilization leads to formation of the human baby. So after fertilization, the different steps involve zygote, which transform into embryo, and finally the embryo changes into the fetus. The fetus, which finally grows into the new human baby. So that's all for this class. Please read and revise the portions that we have read in this class. Thank you very much. See you in the next class.